Morning, everybody.
Dr. Czaykowski.
I'm over there.
Yes, absolutely.
Hello, good morning. Is it on? Yeah. Mr. Premier, Minister Gordon, distinguished guests, board members and staff, I am Brian Schoonbaert, CEO for Prairie Mountain Health, and it's my great privilege to welcome you all here today. Prairie Mountain Health acknowledges that today we are on treaty territory and on the homeland of the Métis Nation. We acknowledge that Manitoba includes the original lands and traditional territories of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Dakota, Ojibwe, Oji-Cree, Dene, Inuit, and homelands of the Métis. Prairie Mountain Health respects the treaties that were made on these territories, and we acknowledge the harms and mistakes of the past. We dedicate ourselves to continued collaboration in partnership with First Nation, Métis, and Inuit communities in the spirit of reconciliation and collaboration. And now it's my honor to introduce and welcome Honorable Audrey Gordon, Acting Minister of Health and Seniors Care and Minister of Mental Health, Wellness and Recovery. Minister.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you, Brian, for the introduction. And thank you to everyone here joining us for this exciting announcement today. I'm honored to have recently been appointed the Minister of Health and Seniors Care, and some of you may recall that I spent about a little over 10 years working in the Winnipeg Regional Health Authority with many different healthcare stakeholders. And so I want to take this opportunity to thank all the healthcare providers and staff across our beautiful province who have worked extremely hard to continue to provide quality care throughout the pandemic. I'm also excited to be here for this historic announcement that I'm sure will improve quality of care for all Manitobans, not only now, but well into the future. Investing in healthcare services in communities throughout Manitoba will not only improve the physical health and well-being of Manitobans, but their mental health as well. This announcement today is a part of Manitoba's Clinical Preventative Services Plan, which was developed and led by clinical leaders and health system experts from across the province. Detailed planning looked at population growth and community health needs, distance to specialized 24/7 health services, and the stability and reliability of the province's health workforce. I'm extremely happy to be a part of the exciting time for Brandon Regional Health Center. And with that, I would like to introduce Premier Brian Pallister. Thank you.
Morning, everybody, friends of healthcare, friends of Brandon and Westman. Honor to be here with you today. If I might, thank you, Audrey, very much for the introduction. And Audrey will do a tremendous job as our new Minister of Health. And I want to say how much I've been impressed, and I know all our colleagues who are here with us today have been impressed with Audrey's support, her work ethic, her intelligence, her integrity. And so, Audrey, all the best to you in your role. And Brian, to you and your team, thank you so much for your efforts on behalf of all of your patients and your support for healthcare in this community and in this region more broadly. We really appreciate it. So pass that thanks on if you would.
I will.
Also pleased to be joined today by several of my colleagues, and I see Doyle Pinuk here. And Doyle, thank you, great to see you. And Blaine Peterson, Lenny Islison is here, of course, and also Greg Nesbitt is with us. And my former student from Neyland High School, I see, who turned out very well. And I thank Rick Crest for being here. It's been a privilege and a pleasure, Rick, to work with you in your time and prior to your time in other roles in partnership, building Brandon, building Westman. So let's hear it for Rick Crest and his council. I thank you, Rick. and so many others who are here, we owe real thanks to, through this pandemic, we've seen how healthcare teams have been able to work in spite of the incredible, and as a consequence of the incredible challenges that we've had to face together to serve the needs of Manitobans and those as well who are visiting our province from elsewhere on occasion. And so I look at you, Lanette, and say thank you so much for your leadership through this process, and to Dr. Roos and your teams, because this has been a tremendous challenge for all of us, but tremendously important for the people of Manitoba, and you've risen to that challenge. So thank you so much for what you've done. So it is a pleasure to be here in my adopted hometown of Brandon and say welcome to everyone. The future of healthcare in Manitoba is better because of what we're doing and what we're going to be announcing today. I want to also say that since we took office in 2016, we've maintained the most significant investments of any Canadian province per capita in education, families, and in healthcare, number one. And we do that because we believe those are the priority areas that need to be served. These are the vulnerable people we need to care for. And our vision for healthcare is a bold one. It's a transformative vision. It's based on improving access to healthcare. It's based on reducing wait times. And it's based on making sure that services are available closer to home. I see some media here today who have come from Winnipeg, and I thank them for being here today. But they know that that trip, as hard as it might have been for them, is made much harder when people have to travel from Westman into Winnipeg or from the Parkland into Winnipeg when they need health care. Our vision for the future of health care involves a lot less of that. A lot less of services closer to home, accessible to people when they need them and where they need those services. And it's better for their families too, in support of those patients who will need that care, to make it available closer to home. So today, we take a significant step forward in achieving these goals. It gives me great pleasure today to announce our government's historic record investment of nearly $812 million to build, renew, and expand our healthcare sites right across Manitoba and improve the quality of care for all Manitobans now and well into the future as well. This commitment today is the largest healthcare commitment in the history of the province of Manitoba, and it is going to support 38 projects in all regions of our province. It will form the foundation of Manitoba's new provincial clinical network. Now, this is a system, Lanette will tell you more about it, I think, in a minute, but this is a system that will allow health services to be more accessible, enhance their quality and the reliability of care, and reduce, as I mentioned earlier, our provincial wait times. Now, these initiatives have been identified as part of Manitoba's clinical and preventative services plan. And I should mention that this plan was developed and led by our clinical leaders and our public health system experts from all across the province of Manitoba. These 38 projects will include some new facilities. They will also include renovations and expansions to existing ones. They will greatly reduce the need for many patients and their families to have to travel long distances for care by providing more services in the community that is closer to home. And that brings me to the second part of today's historic $812 million announcement. I'm pleased to share that approximately $70 million will be committed to enhancing health services right here in Brandon, by establishing the Brandon Regional Health Center as a centralized hub of specialized services for Westman. This $70 million investment will support two major advancements. One, the expansion and renovation of clinical spaces within the health center, and secondly, enhance cancer services at the Western Manitoba Cancer Center. Construction on these Brandon projects is expected to begin next year and will be completed by the summer of 2025. Congratulations, Brandon. Now, I get a little defensive because I know the internet's alive with intelligent comment, but some of it isn't that intelligent. Some of it has said that I favor Brandon too much. And I just have to add today that this is part of a clinical plan that was developed by our health experts and is not politically led in any way, shape, or form. And I would secondly say that It builds on other major infrastructure announcements that we have made since we came to office at health facilities throughout the province. And just to give you some examples, those would include construction of the Selkirk Regional Health Center, new emergency departments in Flin Flon, new emergency department at the PAW, Winnipeg's Grace Hospital, St. Boniface Hospital in Winnipeg. These are province-wide improvements, and they're being made because accessing the healthcare system, whether it be for a test, a diagnosis, or treatment, can be stressful. It can be scary. We all know that. But now, imagine if you have to leave the comforts of your own home, your own neighborhood, and move to somewhere else halfway across the province or further. That just adds to that stress. Alleviating that stress and making these services available to people all across the province is the right thing to do, and I am confident that by investing in healthcare services in communities throughout Manitoba will not only improve the physical health and well-being of Manitobans, but as Audrey alluded to, will improve their mental health as well by reducing the degree of stress that is inherent in having health issues. So as someone from central Manitoba and western Manitoba who has attended university here in Brandon University, I am proud to say that I know how well the community and the region of Westman in our province works together. Community development and community work on healthcare and many other community issues is central to our success here, and it's been central to our success throughout the history of this area. Healthcare is no different. And so today's announcement and these targeted initiatives are going to build up Brandon as a healthcare hub, offering Westman people many services that currently require driving to Winnipeg. Our government's investing in better healthcare. We're investing in health and well-being of the people and communities of all our province. Today's a great day for the future of healthcare in Manitoba, and as I always say, and today is indicative of it, the only thing better than today in Manitoba is going to be tomorrow in Manitoba. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Premier. Manitoba's Clinical and Preventative Services Plan has been developed by clinical leaders and health system experts from across the province, just like the Premier mentioned, of which Prairie Mountain Health has been happy to participate. Our staff and physicians have been all along the way. Two of the many goals of the Clinical and Preventative Services Plan is providing for a coordinated and consistent care approach to be applied across the province. And secondly, looking for ways to improve healthcare access and capacity within our large, geographically diverse province. Further to those aims, today's announcement is the next step for the Brandon Regional Health Center's exciting future role as the province's intermediate hub for Western Manitoba. The enhancements planned for the Brandon Regional Health Center's intensive care unit, neonatal intensive care unit, and the new additional medicine beds will provide the necessary infrastructure and supports to continue to provide excellent care to our patients, clients, and residents. Brandon Regional Health Center has always been proud to serve the communities in which it supports all around, and we are excited to be able to continue this service in an expanded way. Our planning for these expansions will be built upon and consistent with the province's care models and will be based on the latest research in care environments to best support recovery, wellness, and family involvement in care. By increasing our capacity in both the ICU and NICU, we will have the ability to care and manage more critically ill adults and infants closer to home. I would now like to introduce Lanette Siragusa, Chief Nursing Officer, Provincial Lead of Health Service Integration and Quality for Shared Health. Lanette.
Thanks, Brian. Good morning, everyone, and thank you to the Premier for inviting me here to Brandon for this very exciting announcement. As the Premier has shared already, these investments in health capital infrastructure will build the foundation for better health services in our province. Manitoba's clinical and preventive service plan is our roadmap for better care. It outlines the need for improved access, quality, and equity across our health system, shorter wait times, as well as the ability to provide services closer to home. The plan and its recommendations were developed by clinical experts and health system leaders from across the province, and it also includes feedback from thousands of Manitobans, both healthcare workers and community leaders, as well as advisory groups. It's based on evidence and it's based on data, and it is also informed by local clinicians who know what their communities need now and going into the future. It has been a long 18 months since we first announced the Clinical and Preventive Service Plan. Feels like forever, actually. And the pandemic has enabled us in some ways to come together closely to collaborate and find innovative solutions to provide care and a response for our Manitoba citizens. It's also, though, highlighted gaps that have been in our system for a long time, and new challenges that have arisen, which we need to address now. We know that we can do better for Manitoba patients, and we know that we can improve services for people who live in rural, northern, and remote communities, so that your access to healthcare services are not just reliant on where you live. The plan includes investments to support healthy aging, as well as resources that will help better manage chronic disease, which we know is rising in our province. We are celebrating here in Brandon today investments that will build up critical care capacity in our province overall, but will also allow us to provide care for our sickest and our smallest patients in Brandon through the skilled teams working in the ICU as well as the NICU. These ICU investments, by allowing to expand the service here, will also have ripple effects in that the types of surgery we provide, the capacity for surgical patients, will also be enhanced. And the investments in cancer care services, so that Manitobans who are receiving treatment can do so now much closer to home. Clinical teams have been providing input into these capital investments and health service improvements that will be supported by the $812 million investment. There is more to come, and I am very optimistic about the improvements that we are going to make for Manitobans. And over the coming weeks, we will be meeting with more experts and healthcare providers and community leaders, Indigenous partners, other Manitobans who will help us inform what the services will look like and how we make sure that we are able to address the unique needs of the Manitoban, the population we serve. This is Manitoba's plan. It will be implemented in stages with meaningful consultation to make sure that we achieve the improved outcomes that we aim to achieve. As Manitobans, we all have a stake and a role in ensuring that our healthcare system can deliver the best care possible. The clinical teams and leaders involved in the development of the clinical plan, its recommendations, and these investments are committed to building a better healthcare system. And I am thankful for the efforts of all the teams and the individuals who have contributed to this work so far. And I look forward to the voices and the contributions of others yet to come. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Lanette. And now I'd like to introduce Dr. Piotr Czaykowski, Provincial Medical Lead, Oncology and Hematology for Cancer Care Manitoba to say a few words. Thank you.
Good morning, and thank you very much. Thank you, Premier Pallister, Minister Gordon, Mr. Schoonbaert, and Ms. Siragusa. On behalf of Cancer Care Manitoba CEO, Dr. Srinivasaratnam, I bring greetings to all of you. Just a little bit of history. In the late 1970s, the Manitoba Cancer Treatment and Research Foundation pioneered the delivery of cancer drug treatment closer to home through its community outreach programs and through working very closely with very dedicated rural family physicians and with all of our regional partners. Since 2011, Cancer Care Manitoba has been able to provide radiotherapy treatments closer to home for those in Western Manitoba through the Western Manitoba Cancer Centre here in Brandon. With the investment announced today, building up a specialized service hub, we are well on the way to being able to expand the services we provide to Western Manitobans. With a new bunker and a new linear accelerator radiation machine, we will have increased confidence in the sustainability of our radiation treatment delivery. It will be easier for us to manage planned and unplanned machine downtime. The new machine will also permit us to provide more sophisticated radiation treatment that in many instances will mean shorter, more convenient treatment plans, and will further reduce the need for patients to travel to Winnipeg for treatment. With the expansion of the Western Manitoba Cancer Centre's physical space, we will also be able to realize a long-standing goal of moving more specialized cancer care to Brandon. We are very excited to have recruited an enthusiastic Western Manitoba born and bred medical oncologist who will be starting his practice alongside our two radiation oncologists and alongside our outstanding crew of family physicians in oncology who already provide care here. In the future, we envision bringing additional cancer and blood disorder specialists to Manitoba's second largest population hub. The announcement today paves the way for this to become a reality. Although we are talking today about increasing resources in Western Manitoba, we really have to emphasize that this has implications for all Manitobans as it allows us to increase capacity in the system as a whole. There is close alignment between the province's clinical and preventive services plan and Cancer Care Manitoba's provincial approach to care. The roadmap to cancer control for Manitoba calls for patient-centered and community-centered care. We are talking about providing timely access to high-quality care closer to the patient's home and, importantly, to their support systems. The integration that the province's clinical service plan promises will strengthen and ensure formalized pathways provincially that will improve timeliness, improve the patient experience, and improve outcomes. We anticipate better integration between cancer care clinical staff and the other services so important to cancer care, diagnostic services such as radiology, laboratory medicine and pathology, and clinical services such as surgery, internal medicine, and palliative care. This integration will provide a net benefit to all of our patients. Historically, healthcare has been planned in silos. The clinical plan will break down these silos and bring linkages that allow for more successful and efficient provincial planning. I don't think I need to remind you that nearly half of us, think about that, nearly half of us will be diagnosed with cancer in our lifetime, and essentially all of us will be touched by cancer in some form. Provincially, nationally, globally, we need to be ready for the projected steady rise in cancer diagnoses and the ever-increasing time patients live with their cancer. Working together provincially and expanding our ability to deliver high-quality cancer services is a step in the right direction to achieving cancer control in our province, in improving the patient experience, and providing better care for all Manitobans. So thank you again for the opportunity of acknowledging this great investment.
Thank you, Dr. Czaykowski. This brings us to a close today, but before I wrap up, I'd like to take this opportunity to again thanks to Premier Pallister for this great announcement for Brandon. And thank you everyone for being here today. However, it would be amiss if I didn't take this opportunity to acknowledge the staff in Prairie Mountain Health. As the Premier mentioned right at the beginning, it has been through our staff that we have been able to meet the demands of the pandemic over these last number of months. They have gone above and beyond, answered the call of duty through these extremely busy and challenging times. A sincere thank you to all the staff for their dedication to our patients, clients, and residents that we serve each and every day. Thank you again. And we'll be taking some questions at this point.
So the announcement today is specifically for the capital infrastructure, the bricks and mortar that we're going to build to provide better support, better services for patients and the people of Western Manitoba here. There is already been announcements about the internationally educated nurses, as well as additional 400 seats per year for nursing. So more will be ongoing, but that is a separate announcement for that.
Yes, there will be some announcements. They will be later. This is the first of the announcements today. That's a very good question. I think maybe I'll just mention that, of course, it is based on the latest research in wellness and care. The pandemic definitely has taught us a lot over the last number of months, and we will definitely and have already incorporated some of those thoughts and I guess, experiences over the last number of months. Do you want to mention anything specific?
No, I would just say the expansion to the ICU was part of the clinical plan 18 months ago, but you're right, with everything that's happened related to the pandemic, there probably is a closer eye. There always is an eye on infection prevention and control, but certainly having experienced what we've been through, that will be part of the planning as well. Well, what we need to do is make sure we have that flexible capacity, both in the space and the equipment and the staffing, as we always have, so that we can wax and wane when we need to. Right. So the clinical plan was a guiding document, a direction where we wanted to go. But it, because of the situation with the pandemic, it really highlighted to us what the first priorities need to be in the plan. So as I said, we always had ICU building more capacity in Brandon. But because of the pandemic, that was expedited as well. And as we continue to make announcements and stage out the capital investments and the services that go with it, you will see that there is close ties with COVID and the impacts that we've experienced over the past 18 months.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Thank you for coming out today, and stay safe.